I'm a physician scientist that does clinical research. I really, really love the patients. I have a passion for my patients. My patients are all enrolled on clinical trials. I test for the first time in human beings novel vaccines or other therapies to stimulate the immune system to help people who are resisting and fighting cancer or HIV infection. And what we're trying to do is basically strengthen their immune systems so that their immune systems can better fight off the cancer or the HIV. I always wanted to be a nurse, and I didn't think about being a physician until we moved to New Rochelle and we got a new pediatrician, and my pediatrician was a woman. We were sitting in her office and in the waiting room, and she came out, and I was like, she's a girl! And it was then that I got that I could be a physician. One of the most important things that I would say to students, be very wary of people who don't even want to give you a chance, who tell you what you can't do. I had people who told me my first semester of college before I even took my first course, maybe you'll have to consider something else other than medicine. I'm like, what? I haven't even taken my first class. And you're telling me that I can't be a physician? That's the number one challenge that I find with a lot of students, is that somebody put something on their hard drive and somebody told them something about, well, who do you think you are and what makes you think you can do this? And have you ever seen anybody do this? And what I think is really hysterical is, and what I love about science, is we're always doing impossible things because everything at one time was a thought in somebody's mind. You read stories about inventors, and all they say all the time is people like, yeah, you can never do that. Oh, that'll never happen. Oh, no, that won't. Yeah. Oh, cancer, damn, we're never going to cure that. Not. We can. We have to believe that we can. That's why we're here. That's why we do what we do. We could make a very, very dramatic difference and a huge leap forward in cancer treatment by harnessing the immune system to attack tumors. And it's particularly challenging because the immune system normally does not attack self. If you attack self, then you get bad things that happen. Autoimmune diseases like Crohn's disease, inflammatory bowel disease, ulcerative colitis. On the other hand, tumors are self tissues that have gone bad. And you want to get rid of stuff that's gone bad. And so finding that delicate balance of how to stimulate the immune system to attack the tumor, which is self gone bad, but then not attack any of the other healthy normal tissues, that's the real mystery. That's the real challenge. If we're able to train the immune system to either first stabilize the tumors and then shrink the tumors, but then also always recognize if they ever come back, so that they stay away, that will be a dramatic leap forward that will really help the world.